have you picked
Okay,
up?
so nature of matter, I think all of you have in all the batches, nature of matter has been started, and you have a little bit idea of solid, liquid, and gas, and I think you have also idea which goes what is the motion of particle in solid, what is the motion of particle in liquid and gas, and which diffuses fast. Yes, all of you know the diffusion. Yes, okay, so diffusion related questions related to the particles arrangement, related to the particles motion. So don't worry, it is a very interactive, the questions, you find that the questions are very well framed and it is not that tough, but I am sure that definitely you are going to make mistake, because after reading options, my last class experience was people were, as sir said, that students try to give answer as fast as possible, but at that time they miss the right option. So take your time and give the answer only after, when you are very sure that okay, this option is correct, then only mark the answer, because you don't have option to you don't have option to you can't change your answer once you are done. Okay, so take your time and answer it, and don't worry, you will find nothing is very tough, or you have not everything you have learned already learned.
Okay,
Okay, so sir, should we start?
now, just a minute. I'm saying, guys, if you spend time on chatting with others, then probably you'll miss the timing. So all attention on the quiz now. Whatever you have to
Ah,
see.
yes. So diffusion has not done in arena. Don't worry. That the diffusion is nothing but particles move from higher concentration to lower concentration.
Will be
Okay?
common in this group, don't worry. Now,
Very easy. Otherwise, I will explain it. If you have any doubt, I will explain in that. Diffusion just means when you open, when you allow the gas from one pressurized container, if you allow it to expand, it will go from higher concentration to lower concentration. That's it. Don't worry, in one, two questions, you will understand the concept. Okay?
again, guys, the agenda is not to see people topping the chart and all that stuff. The agenda is for you to understand and get the questions straight. Yes, there will be a fun element that we all would like to have. I am myself participating, by the way, so I'll give you a tough competition. See, now the other thing is, in case you, let's say there's a lag, there's a glitch or something, do not worry. Don't really panic. This is because it's an internet-based thing, so might happen. So hence, don't worry. Focus on the solution part. So let's say if you get some question which is not clear to you, would request you to mark those questions and take it down. And we have planned it in such a way that towards the end we discuss everything, or during the quiz itself we keep on discussing all those things. Okay? No, I will not get everything right. I am learning from. I am taking some classes from Prabhat sir as well, so don't worry. So I'm as good or as bad as you all. Chalo, so let's start, guys. All the best. Let's see.
Okay, fine. Should we start, sir?
Yeah, we can start, right?
It's PM now.
Okay, please, your mic's on mute.
Yeah, so this is the first question, guys. So, Prabha, this is last question, I believe.
Which substance are the particles close together? Oh, no.
Just a minute, just reset it, reset it. This is go to present.
What?
Guys, just a minute, just a minute. You have to present it from here. Just a minute, guys. We'll restart. There was some issue. Yeah, from here, present it. Yeah.
My quiz is not opening.
Go to www.menti.com and put the number in the. I'm pasting it in the chat
Should
box.
we reload? So, the quiz is not opening again.
No problem, no problem. Just 2 minutes.
Just a minute.
Prabhat sir, you have to go to the presentation mode. Play from here, yeah.
Sir, your presentation, no?
No, no, you have to go to your presentation, go there.
Yes.
And now press the blue button there. Yeah.
Yes. So are you ready, guys? Now we are starting.
Wait,
the first question to you is.
Let people join in. Yeah. Let people join in. Let people join in and then start. Yeah, I think all of you are there. All of you are there in the thing. Yes, very good. So www.menti.com. If you're not able to log in, change the machine, change the phone, or you know, it will be an internet glitch because all others are able to do it. So change the machine maybe. Yeah. So yes, Siddhant, all okay, Siddhant Agarwal, KRM. So can we start? All of you are ready? Yes. Go ahead, Prabhat sir. Yeah, here's the first question, guys. Yeah. Look at the screen and there will be four options. The question says, in which changes do the particles move further apart? So which changes do the particles move further apart? Gas to liquid is W, liquid to solid is X, and solid to liquid is Z, and liquid to gas is Y. So all of you, you know, you will get 90 seconds for each problem, each question.
And you can see the timer, which is on the left bottom, on the left of, you can see there is a green sign. By that you can understand that time, half time has already passed. Now you have 40 more seconds.
And if all of them and all of you have entered the, let's say, answer, then automatically we'll move
only
on.
Only two students. Sir, have you entered? Only two answers are left.
I have entered.
Only two students have not entered.
Two have not entered. Yes, fastest finger. Yes, it is there. So one more is to be there. You know, he has to put or she has to. Otherwise, we'll have to wait. Yes, I think it's done now. 63.
Okay, still, I think 63. One more is there.
No problem.
Okay.
We'll wait. Yeah. Yes. So 3, 2, 1. So yes. So this is the answer.
Answer is D. Okay. So
you can explain.
Any doubt?
So show them the leaderboard, okay, maybe. Yeah.
Yes, sir.
So this is the, okay, so Parth Jain is on top, then Dhruv, Jagra, Vignesh, Monisha, Naomi, Rishabh, Arthur, Anush and Srijan. Well done, guys. Okay, easy. Okay, so Parth was fastest, 991. So out of 1000, he gets 991. And the 10th, and I believe all of you would be getting the individual scores as well, or at least individual rankings. Yeah.
Okay. Those who are marked wrong, for them I will tell you, whenever solid converts into liquid, particles move apart. Whenever liquid converts into gas, particle further move apart. That's it. That's very easy question. Yes. Any doubt?
Answer was D. Anyone who wants to get it explained once again can put an X so that we can monitor and help you with the question.
If you want explanation in detailed explanation, you can write there. Okay. Fine.
Okay. Great. Great. Oh, these are the ranks they are saying. No worries. Let's go to the next question. Guys, ready? Be ready for the next question. On your mark. Now, next question is here. So two diagrams are given, three diagrams rather. Which change occur during boiling? Yes. Now you have to keep your mics on mute always. Prabhat sir, you can make me host so that I can control that.
Okay.
Yeah, everyone has voted, so you can go move. Leave that. You can just move to the answers. Okay, so I got it wrong. So sad. Wrong answer, it says. I don't get any point for this. Good, but still there are few people. So that C, which you see now, that the person C is me. So I have, okay. Okay, here is the updated leaderboard. This time, Parth, you were a little slow. And who was the fastest among all? It was Monisha.
Monisha.
Very good, Monisha. Keep it up. Keep it
Yes,
up.
Monisha, you can now beat Parth and others also. At the end of the game, you will find that there is a huge change in the leaderboard. So try your best, give your
This is the
best.
next question, guys. Come on. So if you are on a phone, you can click, it will become, or you can go to, let's say you can use the double finger zoom in if it is not that legible. And you can also play it in landscape mode if you're on a mobile, so that you can read the options. So options will be there. In the landscape mode, it goes down, right? So the question says, which statement about the physical states of substance X is correct? Okay, well done, very good. Lots of people have already answered. There are 15 more to go. So you can. States are jumbled up. Yes. States are jumbled up. So that's why, everyone has voted. Very good. So we can go to the solution. Oh my God. So that's, again, there are few people who have not got it correct.
Okay.
So you can explain, sir, what was the question and
Yes,
how.
yes.
Yeah, but you start. Okay, this is a leaderboard. Yeah, you can. Yeah, okay, very good. So now the board has changed and Monisha is again fastest. Very good, Monisha. Keep it up. Srijan, good fight. Okay, so you're.
Okay. Now see the obs question was with the diagram shows the arrangement of this. Okay, which statement of about the physical state is correct? Okay, so to answer this question, first option was particle in state one vibrates about the fixed position. Okay, state one, if you have noticed, it was liquid. First I will write what state one was liquid. Okay, and state two was, if you remember the question, then I'm writing like this. If you don't remember, should I open the question again? State two and state three. Please let me know if you have any doubt. State three was solid, okay, because particles were very close to each other. So in partic in state first option was particle in state one vibrates about a fixed position. No, in liquid particle moves from one place to another. It does not vibrate. They move from one place to another. But in solid, what happens? They just vibrate about their mean position. Okay. Next option. State one changes to state two by diffusion. Okay. It does not change by diffusion. It changes by evaporation. You need to evaporate or boil. Okay. So it is not correct. C option. State two changes directly to state three by condensation. No. By condensation, gas will convert into liquid. No, not directly by condensation. So last option was the substance in stage three has a fixed volume. Very, it's a true. Whenever you have a solid, it has a fixed volume. Okay, gas, liquid is also having a fixed. It takes the shape of a container, and gas also. Gas does not have a fixed volume. It can change. Depends on the container. Any doubt?
Yeah, so I have a question for all of you. How many states of matter are there? How many states? Five.
Five.
Five. So why are we studying only three here? What is the fourth and fifth? So all of you know all of that. There is a famous scientist from India who is involved in the fifth state. What is that? Who's the scientist? Yes. Good. Very good. Very good. Nice. Nice to know that. And any example of fourth state? What is fourth state? Someone said. What is fourth state?
Inclusion.
No, fourth state. Name is plasma. Example of a plasma state? Lightning. Oh, good.
The molecules in the sun are in a state of plasma.
Oh, great. Okay, great. How do you know that?
Oh,
If you have.
we learned it in chemistry in sixth grade.
Is it? But then we haven't been anywhere closer to sun. How do we know that it is plasma state?
Because of that, some fluorescent substances or something.
So have you ever seen solar wind, Anush? Right? How do we know? How do we establish this fact that, hey, this is made up of plasma and nothing else? How do we know that? There's a very famous, you know, revolutionary invention in the history of science which led to all of that. It's called spectroscopy. Okay, so yep, there is a you know, instrument called spectroscope which let us know what is every star is made up of hydrogen and helium and things like that. Yep, so you will learn about all of that a little later. But then my question was this, that, you know, you should be asking this, that how do we know? How do you know that it is made up of hydrogen? Sun is 150 million kilometers away, something like that. So how do we even figure out that it is made up of? No, that's your talk, Raghav. You're talking about Doppler's effect. That gave us the idea that universe is expanding. That red shift you're talking about. Anyways, so let's go and move to the next question. Good that you know there are five states of matter. Great.
Okay, next question is,
okay, in which process
do particles move closer together but remain in motion? Options are also there.
Oh, I have to also vote. This time I am going to, Monisha was on, you know, on the first, in the first position. This time I am going to be in the first position. See, I have got all the three wrong answers so far, so this time I am determined to get correct. In which process do particles move closer together but remain in motion? Freezing. Okay, you have already voted, Monisha. That's not fair. You should have waited for me. Yeah. So I vote for freezing. Let's see if I get it correct or not. Yeah, so all of you vote, yeah, complete your marking the answer so that we can move ahead. No, I'm trying my level best, Srijan, to get it right, but I'm really weak in, you know, my chemistry is not that great. Okay.
Mantra.
Prabhat sir, put everyone on mute. Yeah.
Yes sir.
Okay, so yes. Okay, here is the timer and it's over. So I took 31.983 seconds to answer because I was struggling with the answer actually. I got frozen. Prabhat sir, you're there? Hello? Yeah. Go to the next slide, please. Prabhat sir, you there? Hello. Yeah, Prabhat sir, can you hear me? Hello?
Sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah, go to the next slide, please. No problem. No worries.
Okay, answer. Next question, guys.
Yeah, you can explain the answer at least. Achha, after this.
Oh, okay, after this question, I'll explain.
Don't worry, that answers have been registered. Don't worry. It was just that it got stuck. Yes, so next question is, just click on the, or you know, you have to just what do you say, zoom it in while doing it on this thing. Your answers have been registered, don't worry. You're stuck. So the changes that occur when a substance changes state are shown below. So Prabhat sir, you can zoom in your screen for those who can see from here itself.
Okay.
Maybe just increase the, you know, view 100%, maybe 120-120% like that. Oh.
No.
You click on the this thing, is it?
On screen I touched, sir, that's it. I clicked on string names.
Oh.
So otherwise, okay.
Explain the answer, Quinn.
Okay, fine. I'm explaining both the questions. First, I'll explain this one, then I'll go to the next last one also. So in this question, there was a change that occurs when substance changes. I think most of you were not able to read that. So the changes that occur in the substance change like this. So it was given solid. Okay, and okay, so just give me 1 minute. I will show the question only on the screen.
Yeah. Please go ahead. No worries.
Hassan, stop sharing for 1 minute. Just made the students.
You can just show the PPT maybe. Shall I show from my end?
Okay, so here is on the screen I'm sharing.
You can just share, Prabhas sir, no worries. You can go ahead and share. You can explain on the thing itself. No need to show the question, no worries.
Okay, so here the
big paper also you can show, yeah, no problem.
The question was like, if solid converts into the first, you have this solid, it converts into liquid and then it converts into gas. That this was the question, and this process was W, Z, X and Y. W, Z, X and Y. Okay.
Sir, I can't see your screen.
Yeah, we can see that. Who's that? Just relog. Just not log out and log in.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Can you see my screen?
Yes? No.
You can just relog. Just come out and then relog in.
Oh, okay.
Okay, this was the question. Can everyone see now?
Yeah, it is visible. It is visible. Go ahead.
Yes. So the question was the change. It was the first process. Which process W, X, Y, Z is occurring in the following four situations? Butter melts on warm day. So butter melts means solid to liquid. So solid to liquid must be the answer of first. Okay. So if you see the options, solid to liquid is W. So, okay. Answer will be among A and B. What is the next process? Water condenses on a cold surface. Water condenses on a cold surface means liquid becomes solid. Liquid becomes solid. Water condenses on cold surface means liquid becomes solid. So next will be Z. Just a minute. They have given solid, liquid. Butter melts on a warm day. Butter is a solid and it becomes liquid. First one is W. Second, water condenses on a cold surface. When it condenses means gas converting into liquid. Condenses they have written. Okay, gas converting into liquid is nothing but W. So Y. So what is the answer? W and Y. Only option you can see W and Y is B. Okay. Okay. If I go to the next two options, the volume of liquid ethanol in an open beaker reduces. What happens when there is a open beaker of ethanol? Okay. So what will happen? Ethanol is liquid. Yes. And it vaporizes because it has a very less boiling point. Okay. So it is a volatile liquid. So it converts into gas. So answer is X. So this is X. What is the last? Ice forms inside a freezer. Okay, inside a freezer, liquid convert into solid. Z. So answer is B. Is it clear to all of you? Okay. Any doubt? No? Okay. Fine. If I move to the next question was, means last previous question. This was the question. Which of the following, in which process do particles move closer together but remain in motion? Okay. Condensation. Yes, particles come closer. Are they remain in motion? What happens in condensation? Gas become liquid. Yes, they are in motion. Okay, someone may get confused with the D option, that is freezing. Particles are again coming closer, but they are not in motion. You can say they are in the vibration, but if you say the motion, again, many of you can say that, sir, it is also motion, but you should understand that which is the best option. Condensation, particles are actually moving from one place to another in a liquid. That's why answer is A. Is it clear to all of you?
Any questions, okay, guys? Any questions you can...
Okay, always... no one has any doubt. Very good. I'm moving to the next question.
Yeah, so...
Okay, so get ready for next question.
Yeah, don't click on this. Just let it be like that, maybe. Yeah, so don't zoom it in all that, maybe this thing. So I can see the question very well, so no problem. The diagram shows a sugar lump in a cup of tea. Which two processes must happen to spread the sugar evenly in the tea? Oh my God, people are so fast. While I was reading, people were just answering. This is so, no, let it be. Prabhat sir,
okay,
don't
ask. It is shifting any other, all the other things. But yeah, it is not zooming the photo.
Just let it be.
Okay.
Just let it be. Yeah.
Okay, I read the question for you. The diagram shows the sugar lump in the cup of tea. Which two processes must happen to spread the sugar evenly in the tea? So
now the question is readable, no worries. It is at the end of some, you know, at the end of the user, if you are in a mobile, it comes very, you know, beautifully.
Okay.
So no, I have to answer also, sorry. So the best way to play this is on a mobile. I think it's a, you know, where you get the answer and this thing in a very concise window.
Okay, just two more students. I think two or three more students are there
I have taken some 48.601 second. My God, they are telling in milliseconds also. So they are counting your millisecond hit. Oh my God, 11.4876. People are so fast. Ooh. Oh, someone has taken only 3 seconds. 7.3. Amazing. You guys must go to KBC. Here is the answer, and still, oh my God, there are a few people have not got it.
Okay, fine. So let me discuss the question with you. The question was very easy. There was a tea. You can see the cup of tea, and you have dissolved something. You have put something sugar here, and it is a hot cup of tea. Now see what will happen when you put a sugar. So first thing is, sugar particle is this much big. So what will happen? It will first break into the smaller particle. Smaller particle it will break. Okay, so this is known as dissolving or dissolution. So this is getting dissolved. So first process is, it is getting dissolved by breaking into the smaller pieces. Second is, when let's say it become a small pieces here, okay, what will happen? They will move from one place to another place, because particles of sugar will get pushed by the particles of water, which are also continuously moving. So one sugar particle, first it will reach here, then again one more water molecule will hit this will reach here, then again it will hit, this will reach here. So this is known as diffusion. Okay, by the diffusion, one particle is from the bottom, it will reach to the top. Is it clear? Or it will go around the whole cup. So particles, the sugar will get dispersed or will go to each and every point of this cup of tea. Is it clear? So it doesn't matter whether you are drinking from this side or this side, you will get the same taste. Any doubt, students, guys, any doubt, please let me know.
I think that you can go ahead, sir. Show the lead about.
So I think most of you are trying to give answer fast. That's why you are doing mistake. So please don't do this. Just read the question properly and then give the answer. And I told you options are very good in these questions. So first read all the options and then give answer. Okay, the fastest was Raghav. Okay,
No, no,
Monisha.
Monisha.
Good, Monisha. Okay, I'm moving to the next question.
Yeah. So look at the phone to get, you know, on your side of the browser, what you can do if it's not visible, you can just zoom it in, you know, but in it phone, it appears beautifully.
Okay, I'll read question if you
it's very much clear in the phone side answer. So here,
or
anyway,
should I open the Word file for once so that they can read the question and answer?
It's okay. I think they are not having any problems. If they have
okay.
anyone is having any problem in seeing the question at your end, guys, you are able to see it, right?
Okay,
right,
good,
clear.
Yes.
No problem. Yes. So they are comfortable with the questions. But yes, next time around, probably we have to just to make
okay,
sure
use
that.
The previous question concept. Use previous question concept here.
No, you guessed, huh? Don't guess. Try to, you know, break down, analyze, and then solve like that. So that means we need to explain this question because many people have guessed it.
Very good, Raghav. Raghav has written, I took time, but I got it right. Very good. You should approach like this only.
That's my question also. How do you know that it's right? It has not been declared as of now. Okay. So here you go. And as usual, I am again wrong. So that's sad. And yeah.
Okay.
Oh.
So the question was, again, it was very easy question. If I tell you the question, they have asked, like, you are putting something from this side. From one side, you are putting one salt, and from other side, let's say, they have given lead and iodine. Okay, so lead ion is coming from this side. We'll not bother about what is the ions here, but you should know that PbI2 is yellow in color. That's the only thing. So PbI2 is yellow. Okay, if it is a yellow and the ions are coming from this side and you are getting precipitate on middle. So what does this mean? If you are getting precipitate in center means Pb plus 2 ion must move from this side like this and I minus must move from this side like this. And as I told you, this is nothing but it is a diffusion. You put lead here, but with the help of water molecules, this all lead ion pushed to this side and in the entire container you will find Pb plus 2 and I2 all over they are moving, but due to diffusion, because this is the nearest point, if you see it is the nearest location from this point, these two if I say this point as a A and this point as a B, so nearest point is this only where they can meet, so maximum precipitate you will get in the center only. But why this happened? Because of the diffusion. Is it clear to all of you? It is a diffusion. Whenever you put some solid in a liquid, after some point of time, the solid will diffuse throughout the liquid. Any doubt?
If diffusion was not there, maybe you will not be able to take a cup of tea or coffee and you know, all those, what do you say?
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Yes.
Excuse.
I
Hello.
Have a doubt. Like, if
yeah,
the
yellow
precipitate is on one side, is still that counted as diffusion?
Yes, definitely. Let's say precipitate appears here. This means what? I minus diffusion is very less. I minus is very fat and it does not diffuse very fast. But this means that Pb plus 2 is very fast. It is very small. So, or it is a very light in weight. So it diffuses very fast. Okay, it diffuses like this and it reach here. So what does this mean? Diffusion always dependent on atomic mass. If heavier the molecule, diffusion will be very less. If you put this lighter molecule, diffusion will be very fast. So if appears on one side means one ion diffuse very fast as compared to other. This means you will get here. Let's say I put precipitate on this side. So what is the conclusion? Which ion is heavier, Pb plus 2 or I minus? If I say precipitate appears here, which ion is heavier? Can you guess?
I minus.
Which ion is heavier? Very good.
I minus.
No, no. Pranav, you see which ion is heavier? Because precipitate only form when Pb and I will combine. And precipitase is near to this point, near to A. This means what? Pb is heavier. I minus is coming fast as compared to Pb. Definitely it will never form just below the Pb. I would have written like this. Near to the point A. If precipitate appears here, this means that the ion which is released at A point A is moving with less speed as compared to ion which is coming from B side. And it is moving fast. Is it clear to all of you?
Sir, I don't understand.
Who is this person? Can you identify yourself?
Sir, I'm Sunena.
Yeah, Sunena. Yeah. So your question is, if the precipitate forms at one particular corner, will it still be a case of diffusion, correct?
Yeah.
Yeah. So what Prabhas sir explained was, Prabhas sir, just correct me if I'm wrong, it's still the case of diffusion, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So, and is the explanation okay, Sunena? So that's what he was
mentioning. Can you explain it again? Because I didn't understand it well.
Yeah, Prabhas sir, can you just
Sunena, if I say that there are two colors I take, iodine is green in color now, and lead is let's say yellow in color. Okay, now my point is, if I am saying that precipitate appears on near to A, okay, just assume that distance between point A and B is this much distance. Okay, now if I am saying precipitate appears at this point, what does this mean? That yellow is okay, and at the same time I release Pb plus 2 and I minus in a container. So what does this mean? Pb plus 2 is moving less as compared to I minus, because I minus has moved from this point. This B is here, let's say. I minus has moved from this point to this point. Okay, and A and Pb plus 2 has moved from this point to this point. Which line you see, the longer line? This line or the right side or left side?
So the right side.
Right side line is longer, means right side ion, the ion released at right side or at point B is moving faster. Can I say that?
Yes, sir.
Because that's why it is moving towards the A and it moves a lot in a specific time, because both got the same time to move. And B moved more, this means that B is lighter. Just assume if you have a racing with a friend who is very thin, and let's assume I have not seen you, but let's assume you are very fat. So who will win the race who will run more in 10 seconds?
Sir, the one who is thinner.
One who is thinner. So can I say that here your green thing is moving more? Can I say that it is iodine is a lighter? Can I say like that?
Yes, sir.
Can I say that the green thing is lighter?
Yes, sir.
Yes? So can I say that diffusion depends on the mass of the atom?
Yes, sir.
So is it clear to you? Like here I said that, okay, they have just given you that it is in the middle. So they don't want you to go in that direction. But to give you the clarity of diffusion, I took as a example. Let's say the precipitate appear on this side near to point A. This means that B is lighter. The ion which is released at B is lighter, and ion released at A is heavier. Is it clear?
Sunena? Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Moving to the next question.
So who's now on top? Okay, let's see. So here is the new thing. Monisha still leading the board. Srijan closely following. Okay, so here is very close fight. Only 15 points behind. Oh, Srijan is 15 points ahead. Okay, guys, next question. This time I'm going to get it correct for sure. Okay, so this is, what is this? Crystal of purple potassium magnate 7 was added to each of the beakers shown in the diagram. Now, people, two, three people have already, you are giving me complex, guys. Don't really, mark the answer so fast.
Sir, should I show Krishan in Word file?
No. Question is pretty much visible here at my end.
Okay, fine. Then it's fine.
Now I can zoom it and zoom out. All those things are possible. But the problem is all of them have answered, but I have no clue what you have asked in this question. So let me try. So this result, color spread faster in cold water. Particles move faster at a higher temperature. This is like mathematics to me. I don't understand anything. Okay. So see, people have done. Oh, I have to answer anyway. So let me. Yeah.
One of your friend has asked this question in my previous question, sir. What if I heat the substance at that end? So the person who asked this question, he will get benefit in this question.
Yeah, no, the person will get benefit for sure. He is going to get a reward from me surely. But what's the name of the person who asked that question?
Okay. So.
Okay. Okay, Siddhant asked this question. Okay, Siddhant Agarwal is going to get. Oh my God, this time again. Oh ho, I wanted to get it right, but unfortunately, wrong once more.
Okay, so only very less number of students had made mistake in this. So if I explain this question to you, it is very easy again. Same type of question.
I am on 50 seconds, by the way.
Okay, do you want explanation? Anyone want explanation in this?
No, I don't think so. Anyone who want a, I have a question. Oh, okay. But then we will lose track of the question. The question is.
Okay. So you can see the question here in front of you. This was the question. They have just told that one beaker contains hot water and other becomes cold water. Very easy thing. Whenever there is a hot water, you can understand like speed of water particles, the molecules of water is moving with very high speed. So if I say, someone is moving with very high speed. Okay, let's assume like you are here. Let's say you are the particle of solid. You are the particle of solid. Okay, and someone is coming. Someone is coming here. Okay, let's say you are a particle of solid and someone is coming with very high speed. So if it is coming with very high speed, so you will get impact. You will get a greater impact as compared to one who is coming with lower speed. Yes or no? Yes. Okay. Similarly, here you have a solid particle and here a water molecule. Water molecule, if it comes with very high speed, it helps this solid particle to go more or to travel more in lesser time because water particles are pushing it again and again with very high speed. Okay. So, but if you take a solid particle where water particles are pushing it but with lower speed. So this means that diffusion will be less in this case. Here I can write low temperature and here I can write high temperature. Okay. So if at high temperature, because particles are moving faster, diffusion will be more. So you can write diffusion is more diffusion or near less diffusion. Any doubt? You can understand it by like this example. If some person is coming with high speed, you will get a more impact force or you will travel a more distance after getting impacted or after collision. Okay, I'm moving to the next question.
62nd place. Sad it is. Now I'll improve this time. Okay, so the diagram shows method of separating a substance that contains X and Y. Which types of substance can be separated as shown?
Sir, you have not finished reading the question. Half of them have answered.
Oh my God. No, this is so bad. Oh, okay. So this time I'm going to, this is compounds. No, option A is correct. So I will click on A. No, I don't know. But people are comparing their time. Okay. I took 28.437 seconds, by the way.
Still, it's not half time. Like, you have...
Yep.
You have 50 people have more seconds.
7 seconds, 3 seconds and all that. Oh. People are really, really fast. And they have more, they have better, computer skills than we people. More, we are computer illiterate kind of people. So these people are much smarter. Yes.
Okay, but still 4 students have not answered. Okay, no problem.
No, I'm not doing it deliberately. My knowledge is very limited, guys. So it came down from 3 to 9. Last question, no problem.
You can't see the question. Harita.
Reload, No, you look at your this thing, Harita, in your mobile phone, you can zoom it there or reload. Reload, no problem. Yeah, we have to just figure out why here in your screen it's actually a little smaller in size. Next time we'll make it sure, make it perfect. Okay, here is. Oh,
Okay, very
I still
good.
got it wrong. Once more, I got it wrong. Oh no.
Very good. So I don't think that this question needs explanation. I think most of you are clear, like mixture you have. Whenever there is a mixture, you separate it like this. Compound is a pure substance. Element is a pure substance. Then what you are separating? Nothing.
Oh, is it? Compound is a not pure substance. Compound is a pure substance. Mixture is not. Oh, okay. Okay.
Okay,
Next question.
in this point, I want to ask you one question. Is ice a pure substance? Is water a pure substance? Sorry, is water a compound? Is water a compound? Okay, and is S8 an element? S8 an element? S8.
Sulfur.
Okay, one has written no. S8 an element, molecule. Okay, two have written no. 3, 4, 5, 6 have written no. Okay, S8 is also an element. That's what I want to tell you here. Always remember, definition of element is one type of atom should be there and it should not be separated by the chemical means. Okay, so it is a element. Yes, it is molecule as well. My question was, is it element? You should say, yes, sir, it is element. It is molecule also. No problem at all. Both, it is possible that an element can be a molecule.
A few drops of perfume. Where, oh my God! See, people have already. Oh my God! This is no. This is insane. How can you be so fast, guys? Few drops of perfume were spilled on the floor. Few minutes later, the perfume could be smelled a few meters away. Which two processes had taken place? So this is distillation and condensation, distillation and diffusion, evaporation and condensation, evaporation and diffusion. This time I'm going to get it correct. Yes.
I hope,
And
sir, you
my
are
time.
putting distillation and diffusion.
I have picked up something else this time. I know this time is you're trying to just dissuade me
Everyone has
from
voted
answer.
first time. Okay.
No, yeah. Oh, yes. See, I got it correct. Yes,
Oh,
this time
53
I'm correct.
students have done this question, has done this right. Okay, the question was very easy. When you put a spray on the floor, first it will evaporate and then only it will move. Otherwise, how it will move? So first evaporation is there. Once it become a vapor, then it will start diffusing. Is it clear? So
Yes, chalo.
diffusion can
Let's
take
move on.
place.
I think this is easy for all of them. Great. Next, come on, let's finish this. Okay. Next question. So here is the new chart. Anyways, it's not finished yet, guys. Fight to the finish. Chalo, next. Next answer this time also. And now I'm going to come in the leaderboard. See, the what diagram shows the result of dropping a purple crystal into water. And what water purple crystal after 5 years purple solution chemical what which process takes place in this experiment? Chemical diffusion dissolving. What? This time also I am going to get. I always think that I have clicked, but it doesn't take my. Now it is 25.574 seconds. Good. Now I'm remembering my chemistry days. 70 seconds, 17 seconds wrong. Okay, my screen wasn't loading for like, oh my God. Okay, so here is the answer, and the answer is D. Yes. So those who have clicked D. What? Lots of people. Oh, so then that means you are confused between chemical process and a physical process, I guess. Hence, many people have marked A. It's certain. Now I can explain this very well. See,
Yes, sir, please do.
this is certainly not a chemical reaction, guys. It's just diffusion. And what the other thing was? Something else was there. So hence, I don't see it to be a chemical. Yeah, so those who have marked A, it's not certainly not a chemical reaction,
Okay,
right?
it is. it is not a chemical reaction, and if you want the explanation, this was the question given to you.
So what is purple crystal, by the way?
Huh?
What is this crystal?
Okay, this purple crystal is KMnO4. Okay, purple crystal is for okay, so chemical reaction, it is not a chemical reaction. Second is diffusion. Yes, it will diffuse. The whole thing become purple. Okay, is the dissolving involved? I explained in previous, last few, I don't remember which question, I explained that particle first break into small pieces, that is the dissolving. These questions give you the clarity of diffusion, dissolving and a chemical reaction. Very important questions. So you should not, you should understand all these three concepts.
This was a very easy question. Even I got it correct. See? Next, leaderboard. Srijan is worried about the leaderboard. So you didn't get it correct this time, Srijan. So now, Nitya, we have a new person on first position. Misclicked. Hence I'm saying, you know, accuracy versus speed. This is a game, guys. So you have to be very, very clear whether you want accuracy. Yeah, sorry. Yes, Prabhat, sir, you're saying something?
No, nothing. Sorry, sir.
So the diagram shows how the molecule in the exhaust gases diffuse into the air. Now, those people who are clicking, I will today figure out the names from the log. So they left all these 33, 34 people who have clicked in no time. I will talk to them. I will just try to understand how can they do it so fast. So which statement describes what happens? I am still reading the question. See, not even 1 minute completed. Which statement describes what happens to this molecule next? Okay. Wow, Raghav Pandey, 5.8. Did you all see this question before?
The best part of objective questions is you can see the options which are wrong. If let's say you take your time, you can identify which questions are wrong. So, but if you try to put answers as soon as possible, or if you quickly answer, means you are not reading all the options. So you are reducing the chances of getting correct answer.
Now people are saying that it is, you know, their reading skills which is helping them mark it correct.
In no time,
my dear friend, you will see a different scenario altogether. So hence, never mind. So let's try to, you know, see. No problem. Good. Those who are able to do it fast, as long as you are correct, there is no problem. Okay. Oh wow. So there are lots of correct answers. 56 people. That's nice.
Okay.
And so I am in. Yeah, great. So maybe this could be the last question, right? Or we can finish the quiz quickly. Come on. So let's do it. Nitya is on first position. Okay, good going, Nitya. Very good. Oh, here is the next question. Now this time I also mark it fast. Liquid is heated and boils what? Just refresh the. So that happens, Monish. That's what I was trying to point out. There is always a fine balance between accuracy and speed. So you have to maintain that balance. Initial days, accuracy is more important than speed. When you are, you know, any, it's like a marathon or a, you know, long race, where if you speed up in the initial part of the game or race, you will not be able to finish the race properly. So hence, first accuracy, then speed. Speed will come if you're more and more accurate. Okay, Arushi. Thanks a lot for supporting. Yeah, I have some supporter in my audience. Too small. Yes, Hamsika, you have to, you know, I know, you know, in your, you know, hence next time you keep a mobile phone. In mobile phone, it renders so well. We are also trying to look at how we can make a bigger question.
Oh,
but.
So fine. This question is based on a simple fact that pure substances have a fixed boiling point. This is the thing which we tell in the definition only. Okay, wait, let me, because I know that all of you are focusing on the leaderboard. So after you finish with leaderboard, I will explain the question. Okay.
Yeah, so Nitya, Gandhar, Srijan, Monisha, Vignesh, Siddhant, Siddharth, Nishant, Raghav, Suranjita.
Okay, yeah. So far what I want to, so always remember whenever there is a mixture, the difference in mixture and compound or the pure substance and impure substances, pure substance always have a fixed boiling point, but impure substance is not having a fixed boiling point, it has a range of a boiling point. So sir, should we continue?
Yes, please. Okay. Let's continue. So how many, this is which question number, let's see.
14 number.
Yeah, Monisha has a doubt.
Yeah, okay.
Yes, Monisha, go ahead and ask. Oh, okay, you have already published this question. Oh my god, this fast thing. Yeah, we'll definitely take care of that, Anush. We are ourselves thinking of that. So let us also get some data on how people are responding. Don't worry, I have everyone who's clicking in the first click. I am going to give calls to each one of you. Let's understand how, because if you are really doing it, because I know who has clicked when and whose answer is get, you know, it's correct. Smets.
Okay, why not Smets. Option D in the previous one? Okay, let me see the option D. What was option D? Let me see. Okay, we'll finish this question. I didn't see that.
So other way of looking at this quiz is, you know, those who are really into solving questions, they will not even mind which rank they are right now.
Okay, very good. I will answer. Okay, so okay, I'm coming to this question later. First, I'll explain the previous question. So last option was there is nothing left behind in the test tube. But okay, it's fact, nothing left behind in the test tube. But how does it shows that test tube has a pure thing? Whenever you have a, let's say, when you put your alcohol and water, both will evaporate after some time. Both will evaporate. So it does not says that you have a pure substance in a test tube. Understood? So it's not always true that pure substance, impure substance, it's not always true that impure substance leaves residue after beating. It may evaporate everything. Okay? So now, this question, I think the question was, okay, which substance would compress and for what reason? Yes, gas would be compressed because gas particles are far apart. The answer is B. You people are making mistake in very easy questions. So please take your time. It's request from my side. Otherwise,
so maybe this we can just finish this quiz by the last. This will be the last question, guys. So we are already, you know, we have crossed the limit of time. So yeah, look at your phone and solve it. Okay, so the glass slide is removed. Diagram 2 shows the appearance of the gas jar after 1 hour. There's no D. There is D. Oh.
D option is molecules in bromine and air moved randomly. D option is in bromine.
You show the screen.
Okay.
Show in the screen. Okay. Word file. Don't worry. Hold on.
Yes. So this is the question. These are the options.
No, still a lot of time is left. I think some 30 seconds are left. Already answered. So then that means you have, you know. Okay. Yes. So time's up. And this is the, oh my God. So lots of people are still, so you need to explain this question maybe.
Okay, sir. Fine. Now I'm telling you why this question I put in, earlier I didn't put this question, but after reading the options, I put this question in my, this thing, because the options are very good. What is the option? And I knew that you will take mistake in that. Question was, why, it is very clear that why bromine and gas is mixing. Here, from here, you are getting bromine, Br2, and from here, let's say this is a container, okay, and from the this, and let's say I divide it in the two sections, from here you are getting the air. Okay, it is other way around, no problem. Just write it like air is coming from this side, air is coming from this side, and bromine is coming from this side. Okay, now they have asked why it will form something in which everything becomes same. Okay, this means that bromine and air is everywhere. So first thing is clear that if it is going everywhere, this means that it is a diffusion. Why? Let's say I represent air with a green dot and green lines, and I represent bromine with a pink line. Earlier the situation was like this, but now the situation is you will see pink line everywhere and you are seeing the green line everywhere. You are seeing the green line everywhere. This means that everything has mixed. Everything has mixed means definitely the pink particles, the bromine thing, definitely goes up and reached at this point, because you see the pink line here also. Means this particle has gone to this point, and definitely a particle from the air side, this is a particle from air side, let's say it must have reached to this point, because we have a green line on this side also. This means that it is nothing but diffusion. So answer D is the answer. Okay, many of you have written answer A because bromine is denser than air. Bromine is denser, yes, it is correct. Bromine is denser than air, but it is not the answer. It is not answer because they have asked why they mixed. This is not the reason that it is denser, that's why they mixed. Because of the diffusion they mixed. Is it clear to all of you?
Yeah. So any question this? So hence we will just wrap it up here, Prabhat sir, because time is up and most of them would be, you know, hungry and going for this thing. So they can, you know, just show them the final leaderboard.
Okay.
Final leaderboard. So this will be this will be the final leaderboard for today. No, but, so those who want to quit, as in, you know, now we have to kind of, you know, maintain the timings as well. So yeah. So finally, this is the. Yes, sorry.
So are we allowed to continue the quiz after this?
Let's keep it, you know, one time limit. Who's he, by the way? Who's the person? So, name?
So this is Jagrav.
Yeah, Jagrav. So basically, you know, we have to just keep the time limits also, because, you know, you have to, you have other engagements, and, you know, we have to just keep it in a tight schedule. Never mind, we'll have multiple such things. And I just want, so hence, let us keep it like that for today. And I have one thing to ask to all of you before you leave. So irrespective of who's coming first and all that, see, for us, it's not important. For you might be, because you are more keen to get a rank or something here. Our intention for this leaderboard and all that is just to keep you, you know, give you some bit of excitement while playing this. And, you know, but the more attention in my belief should be, guys, on the understanding part of it. That's, you know, this is lots of quizzes are going to be there. Secondly, if we conduct feedback from you, let's say if we conduct a general knowledge quiz on this, how many of you would be interested to participate? So, you know, this is because I am I follow general knowledge a lot. So hence. Just a minute, Nitya. So we will be doing we will be keeping, let's keep the sanctity of time. So hence today's final leaderboard will be this. We had only a few more questions left, so hence don't worry about your positions and all that. Don't worry about your position. So it is going to be changed, it's not going to be fixed. Now my question was this. Please, I need some kind of feedback on this. One is, do we remove the fastest finger first? First question, vote yes or no. Fastest finger first, yes or no, so that I can, you know, understand how many of you are for it, how many of you are for against it. Accordingly, we'll take a call because this is all recorded. Just write yes or no.
Sir, I have a suggestion.
Yeah, who's this? Introduce yourself and say.
Sir, this is Raghav. I have a suggestion. We can keep the fastest finger first, but like only for 500 points instead of 1000. And 500 points, if you get the answer right, we can give a, we can get a guaranteed 500 if we get the answer right, and 500 for faster finger first.
See, all these, you know, see, our intention, Raghav, is for you to See, the first and foremost, let me be very clear of why do we do Center Mars is not for any entertainment. It's
so
the only.
I have Sunyana here. I have a suggestion to give.
Yes, go ahead.
So I think we can remove the fastest finger first. So even if we keep it, it can be like the first 20 people will get a few points. So because we get more worried about our position and we think we don't know much if the fastest finger first is there.
Okay, so I'll answer this. See, first of all of you understand what, you know, and it is, I am trying to tell you from my own experience, first of all. See, being competitive is, you know, please don't get me wrong, but I'm just going to say, being competitive is a very good thing, but not at the cost of knowledge. So all this knowledge is waste. Many people started saying in the middle of it, eliminate the options and you'll get it fast. Now, this is the first route of disaster for any competitive exams. If you start eliminating at this stage, you will be able to crack exams, guys. But after passing through IITs and all that, I'll tell you from my experience, you will definitely going to flunk in your IIT exams inside because there is no elimination over there. So hence, please understand, right now till 12th grade at least, this is the age to learn. Yes, when you are going to face the competitive exams, we have done statistical analysis on how to pick up choices also and get it right. So we can tell you all of that, but not now, because if I tell you this, you will always be taking shortcuts. I know how to hit upon a correct answer with highest probability. All those things you guys have never, you know, you don't even realize what a level we have done all of this in our life. So hence, I'm saying when the right time comes, when the bridge comes, I will be the first person to tell you how to eliminate, but not now, because if you start eliminating from now onwards only, rest assured, you will be able to ace few exams, but that would be the last exam you'll be able to do it. Because throughout, everywhere you go, the importance will be on how much do you know and not how much did you eliminate. Okay, so hence I again urge for those who are concerned about fastest finger and all that. See, first thing is accuracy. Definitely no point or no doubt.
No, but about. I have a question.
Yeah, just let me finish, Raghav. Let me finish. So what I'm saying is, if you are really concerned about your knowledge, you will just focus on whether you're getting it right or wrong. Forget about the leaderboard. Yes, there will be few people who would like to see themselves there. So let them carry on with that. So that is my suggestion. So this is how I look at it. So if I was there, I would never care who is coming first or second. I would see in 15 questions, how many could I get correct? That's it. Because that's my objective of this hour. So hence, those who want to see themselves there, they let them run fast or whatever. It's their prerogative. Those who want to solve only can come and enjoy or let's say, you know, learn how to solve problems. That's it. Okay. Is that okay? No, Monisha, Menti is just a platform. See, we have our own, we are developing our own platform. We're just, you know, kind of experimenting with this, how you guys, you know, perform. And the idea is you don't realize after this, we download the entire data and we have each and every one's click time. So when you have done what, every data is there with us. We want to analyze because I am very concerned about the fact that most of you are blindly just going ahead just to see your name over there. You're just clicking the option. That's something, you know. No. Don't. Why do you want to stay out of this? Right. So hence my only this thing is why, Monisha, why do you want to stay out of this? See, don't stay out of this. The idea is for all of you to. Oh, this debate. Okay. So hence. Okay. Never mind. So we will share from our experience that here right now, all of us should be worried about, let's say, or focusing on how many did you get correct. That's it. Okay. So that's the only thing. Later on, fastest finger and all that, you don't even realize we have gone to that extent that this 13187 is going to be converted into currency. Now, how cool that would be. Just imagine. So hence, I'm saying, you know, there is, you know, no limitations to what we can do. But then not at the cost of your knowledge, buddies. Please understand, we have gone through this phase and we have experienced very, you know, all these instant gratification thing actually hampers. So please trust me, by experience, I am telling you that we will try to make your learning more productive and effective rather than just superficial. Okay, so thanks for your time. And as I was saying, we want to do a open book quiz. Like, you know, and I am very keen on subjects like history and what do you say, geographies and political science and things like that. I just wanted a response from you. If we do a open book quiz where it will be a data mining kind of a thing, we'll have questions and you'll have to go through the book and answer. Would you be interested in that? So depending on that, we can take a, you know, another quiz or that sort of a thing. And it will be incentivized. Don't worry, all the points will count. Okay, so the idea is this, that let's say we will take up one history topic of yours. I have thousands of questions developed during my preparation days. So all those questions are there. What I can do is I can convert them into quizzes of sets of, let's say, 10s and 15s. And then probably one fine day when you are free and we can set up a timing where you can just come on and you can just do, this thing. Okay, online. Yeah, everything is online. Yeah, the topics will be mostly your social science subjects, but they're not that mundane type. It will be interesting and we will try to make it exciting. Okay. Yes, fastest finger in history. So you have to just read through that. And the best part is you will have the book in front of you. You can just mine the data and. Okay, thus that is the thing. So book will be in front of you. The question will be in front of you. You have to read the book, read the paragraph, find the answer, mark it, and go ahead. Okay, so we'll try to do for history, geography, all those interesting, right? Do you agree? So let's plan it. I will come up with a plan. We'll have a 1 hour quiz on maybe geography, because geography is very close to my heart. So we can start with geography with questions. Okay, so thanks guys. So we'll come up with that and plan it and we'll let you know. So, you know, that way your social science facts will be there in your head. Bye-bye guys. Take care. Good night. And thanks for this. And Kandhar, congratulations. If at all, you know, that means something to you. Monisha, good, well done. Siddhant,
okay,
well done.
Thank you, all of you. And
Vijan, Vignesh, Raghav, Siddharth, Sahana, and Nishant. And those who could not, come up to these top 10, don't worry. So I am worried more about how many you got correct rather than what was your position. So thanks, guys, and see you again next week. Bye-bye. Take care and stay safe. Good night to all.
Okay, bye-bye, goodbye, guys. Thank you.
Anybody saying anything? Yeah.
Yes, sir. In the quiz, the geography quiz, can you not put fastest finger first?
Yeah, that we can do. See, we'll do. See, you guys have to just, you know, bear with us. One day we'll eliminate fastest finger and see how was the response. And then again, you know, we'll keep on evolving because you guys are, you know, we are meeting for the first time. So we'll also take some time to know you well. And then probably, you know, don't worry, we can do all such permutation combinations. So we'll eliminate fastest finger maybe in the next one and see the response and then again come back to. Yep. Okay. Fair enough. See you. Bye-bye. Thanks for suggestions, guys, and thanks for being patient and bearing with us. Nice crowd. Bye-bye. Take care and enjoy your Sunday. Bye.
Okay, bye.
Yeah, Prabhat, you can end the meeting, maybe.